Hello everyone, Professor Franz here. Today we're going to talk about the long-run equilibrium of perfect competition. In this clip, I'm going to explain why is that in the long run, all firms are making a zero economic profit. And second, why is that our market outcome for perfect competition in the long run is efficient. Before we start, let's recap that in the long run, there are no fixed costs. All costs are variable. So some possible fixed costs are like rent or insurance. We know that in the short run, you're stuck in the contract. But in the long run, you can always choose whether you want to renew the contract or not. And therefore, there are no fixed costs in the long run. Second, there is free entry and exit for perfect competition. So if a firm is suffering a loss, then it will exit the industry. If the existing firms in the industry are making a positive economic profit, then new firms will try to enter the industry to share that economic profit. And for simplicity, we're going to assume that all firms are identical. In the next few slides, I'm going to explain why is that in the long run, all firms will be making a zero economic profit. So we start with initial market equilibrium, where the demand and supply determines that price is P star. Each firm is going to take P star as given, and you can see that a single firm is making a zero economic profit because price P star is exactly equal to average total cost. Now suppose there is an increase in the market demand, which will shift our demand curve to the right. As a result, price goes up from P star to B double star. And that will increase the marginal revenue of our firm. As a result, the firm is going to equate a new price and the marginal cost and produce a higher quantity. And then we will have a positive economic profit as a result. The positive economic profit for the firm is the blue shaded area. Now, the economic profit that existing firms are enjoying will attract new firms to enter the market. As a result, market supply is going to shift to the right, which will bring down our price to P star. As a result, existing firms will be making a zero economic profit again. Now, what happens if there is a decrease in market demand? That will cause our demand curve to shift to the left. As a result, the market price is going to go down, and our existing firm will be suffering an economic loss. Some firms that are suffering economic loss will exit the industry, which will shift our supply curve to the left. As a result, the price will bounce back to P star. And then existing firms will be making a zero economic profit again. So we have come to a conclusion that in the long run, every perfectly competitive firm will be making a zero economic profit. Finally, perfect competition is efficient in the long run. You probably noticed that in the long run, we have this triple equality for perfect competition, where the price is equal to marginal cost, is equal to lowest point of average total cost. Now, when we're producing at the lowest point of average total cost, that means we're using the least resource possible. We cannot produce a product at even cheaper means. And therefore, we have achieved productive efficiency. And second, price is equal to marginal cost. That means we have allocative efficiency. Why is that? That means as long as your willingness to pay is greater than the marginal cost, you will get the product. Notice that you don't get this for monopoly. Why is that? We know for monopoly, price is higher than marginal cost. And there is a chance where your willingness to pay falls between price and marginal cost. That means, hey, even though your willingness to pay is higher than the marginal cost, you don't get the product because your willingness to pay is lower than the price. So you will not buy it. But that's just too bad because the consumer is willing to pay a higher price than the marginal cost, the cost of producing one additional unit for the consumer. So this consumer should get the product because willingness to pay is higher than the marginal cost. But unfortunately, As long as your willingness to pay is lower than the price, then this consumer is not going to get the product. But that type of allocative inefficiency happens in monopoly, not for perfect competition. So in conclusion, we know that perfect competition has both productive efficiency and allocative efficiency.